cannot tell you how much we appreciate Kevin Van Blarken and his support. He is actively installing, with the help of the highway department, the equipment that came through from Rob's grant, and we're really beginning to feel like things are happening in our parks. So, that's it.
Great.
So in addition, and this will be news to Marty, Rob and I had our first consultation for the design of the skate park that's going to be installed in Smith Park, theoretically next year. And it was very good discussion we had, and we've talked about how we're going to work the design, keeping the Catskills in mind. So it's going to be sort of a mountain-themed skate park, and we have a lot of space to work with, and they were very, as the skateboard designing park said, he's stoked. So that's moving right along.
Yeah, so what he did is we threw out the idea of trying, he came up with the idea of doing a streetscape, like urban scape, and we kind of balked at that and said, we don't have urban attributes up here, can we make it look mountainy? And he said, well, we just did one on Mount Desert Island up in Bar Harbor. Kevin might like, so he shot us some pictures and it looked really cool, like incorporating boulders and hilly terrain and everything into it, and I think this is going to be a very good opportunity for us.
So it's next year.
So we're going to have to do some fundraising.
But it's important to get this design in a concept so we can start applying for Tony Hawk grants and things like that. But yeah, we're shooting for summer 2019.
And as a consultant pointed out, it's a lot easier to get funding when you can go to people and say, here's a picture of what we're aiming to go than just going and saying, give us money for a skate park. So.
Very exciting stuff.
Yeah.
Good. Thank you. Thank you, folks.
And one more, I forgot. The backstop. It would be nice if it was removed so we could work there. Will the town highway department remove it or
done? I'm looking at I'm looking right at him. He knew. He picked his head up. He was like, oh. No.
I don't know if you want the fence or you don't want the fence.
Usually you want to take off.
I mean, we've got to do the site work so we can have a guy just pull them out.
Okay.
Probably early August, mid August.
Get the report on this thing.
Okay.
Shindigan Day. I am saddened to report that Ms. Tina Rice has resigned from the Shindigan Day Committee.
What?
Busy with other things. So Kara Grant will be assisting with the Shindigan Day. We are moving Shindigan Day down to the Interpretive Center site this year. We've noticed over the past few years we've been dwindling in our vendors. The issue comes that we have no, sad to say, there's no communications available, and people generally do not walk around with a lot of cash anymore. It's a lot of plastic. So to have the Wi-Fi and to have cell service, people can use a square with their electronic devices in order to do purchases right there on site. It's individual to them. And one, we also had Maurice Hinch, he was interred down there this past year. We are celebrating Mount Tremper, Mount Pleasant. So we're gonna go down there this year. We're gonna give it a shot and see how it goes. And then we'll see. We may move around again to every amulet again as we did before, but we'll give this a shot this year and see.
That's a good spot for it down there.
Yeah, I mean, it's right at the entrance of town. We'll see. Yeah. So if you're a vendor and you're interested, we're going to be sent up at the Interpretive Center site on Saturday, August 18th. The event is 10 to 6 during that day. We have food, we have bands, we have beer, we have Keegan Ales is coming in as a sponsor again. We have the human foosball tournament again. We have all the kids' games. So we're looking forward to it and hoping to have another fun day.
Human foosball?
Human foosball, yes, your favorite.
Yes.
Third champion. Yep, past champion. Ambulance.
I'm not playing this year.
No work boots. We're gonna, no steel toed boots this year. But we're going to outlaw those things. That ball flies like a rocket off of those things. All right, with that, we'll move on to public comments and resolutions. Just on the resolutions. Yeah, we got Rick's corner is at the end of the meeting.
I have public comments, but not on that.
I know. You always have public comments. There's no motions, so we'll move on to resolutions.
Resolution Resolution 9118, resolution to pay all bills. Whereas the Department of Audit and Control require town boards to sign and inspect all vouchers coming into the town for payment to number and total amounts from each fund. Therefore, be it resolved that the town board authorize the following vouchers paid. From general, $99,971.12. From highway, $39,365.34. Phoenicia Water, $4,272.53. Pine Hill Water, $1,404.21. Phoenicia Lights, $1,603.24. Chichester Lights, $140.56. Pine Hill Lights, $543.91, for a grand total of $147,300.91. And I move its adoption.
I second. Board Member Alba?
Yes.
Board Member DeScafani?
Yes.
Board Member Storms?
Yes.
Board Member Van Barton?
Yes.
Supervisor Snell?
Yes.
Resolution 9218, authorizing town supervisor to execute documents for consolidated funding application funding for infrastructure improvements for Phoenicia Water District. Whereas the town of Shandaken owns and operates a municipal water system located in the hamlet of Phoenicia, Phoenicia Water District, and whereas the Phoenicia Water District is in need of several improvements, and whereas several projects have been identified for further development, including completion of the High Street Loop, installation of the third finished water pump at the filtration plant, improvements for chemical storage and ventilation, cleaning and disinfection of existing infiltration gallery, and TV inspection of the water storage tank and spring water resources. And whereas community development block grants, CDBG funds, are available for such infrastructure improvement activities through the New York State Consolidated Funding Application, CFA, process, therefore be it resolved that the Town of Shandaken Town Board does hereby authorize the town supervisor to apply for necessary funding up to the maximum $750,000 from CDBG through the CFA process for said improvements, and move its adoption.
Second.
Board Member Alba?
Yes.
Board Member DeScafani?
Yes.
Board Member Storm?
Yes.
Board Member Van Barton?
Yes.
Supervisor Snell?
Yes. 9318, resolution for purchase of replacement ambulance vehicle. Whereas the town of Shandaken ambulance chief has identified a paramedic response vehicle or fly car for replacement. Whereas the deputy ambulance chief has provided specifications and pricing for a comparable and suitable replacement vehicle. Therefore, be it resolved, the Town of Shandaken Town Board does hereby authorize the town supervisor to purchase the vehicle recommended for a price not to exceed $55,000. Be it further resolved that the town supervisor be authorized to enter into any lease agreement necessary to help in deferring costs over a period not to exceed 5 years in order to reduce any immediate impacts on upcoming budget.
Yeah.
I said, oh, sorry.
Wait a second. Any questions?
He had to move.
Move your adoption.
Move it.
And move.
Second.
Board Member Alba?
Yes.
Board Member DeScafani?
Yes.
Board Member Storms?
Yes.
Board Member Van Barton?
Yes.
Supervisor Dennis?
Yes.
And this one, I have to read every single line and every single section of it.
Resolution 94-18, resolution of time accruals for New York State Retirement System. Whereas the New York State Retirement System requires a report be filed with their offices listing those employees and elected and appointed officials enrolled in the system. Therefore, be it resolved that the Town of Shandaken hereby establishes the following as standard work days for elected and appointed officials and will report the following days' work to the New York State and local employees' retirement system based on the timekeeping system records. Robert Stanley, Supervisor, 7 workday hours. Participates in timekeeping, no. Days a month based on record, 22.28. Gail Elba, town board, 7 day hours, no. In timekeeping, 2.83. Days a month based on record. Peter DeScafani, town board, 7 workday hours. Participates in timekeeping, no. Days a month based on record, 2.05. Bay Storms, town board, standard workday hours, 7. Participant timekeeping, no. Days, month based on record, 3.22. Kevin Van Blarkum, town board. Standard workday hours, 7. Participates in timekeeping, no. Days, month based on record, 2.17. Joyce A. Grant, town clerk. Standard day hours, 7. Participate in timekeeping, no. Days, month based on record, 22.74. Eric Hoffmeister, Highway Superintendent, standard work day hours, 8. Participate in timekeeping, no. Days, month, based on record, 29.19. Peter DeMonica, Assessor, Chair. Standard day work hours, 7. Participates in timekeeping, no. Days, month, based on record, 14.96. Dave Channon, Assessor, Part-Time. Standard day work hours, 7. Participates in timekeeping, no. Days, month, based on record, 5.14. Wendy Lockwood, Justice Clerk. Standard day work hours, 7. Participates in timekeeping, no. Days, month, based on record, 15.22. Chad Story, Police Chief. Standard day work hours, 8. Participates in timekeeping, no. Days, month, based on record, 10.96. Richard Mulieri. Elected appointed title, Deputy Ambulance Chief. Standard day hours, 8. Participates in timekeeping, no. Days, month, based on record, 3. Richard Riccardello, Phoenicia Water Superintendent. Standard work day hours, 7. Participates in timekeeping, no. Days, month, based on record, 23.09. Donald Clark, Pine Hill Water Superintendent. Standard day hours, 7. Participates in timekeeping, no. Days, month, based on record, 13.13. And I move its adoption.
Second.
Board Member Alba?
Yes.
Board Member Visapai?
Yes.
Board Member Collins?
Yes.
Board Member Van Barca?
Yes.
Supervisor Lane?
Yes.
Resolution number 95-18, authorizing Towns Planning Board as legal agent for local law number 2 of 2018 regarding Big Indian Zoning Map Amendment. Whereas the Town of Shandaken Planning Board, in a letter dated on August 28, 2017, made a recommendation to amend the zoning map for the Town of Shandaken, specifically regarding two parcels located in Big Indian. And whereas an introductory local law entitled Zoning Map Amendment, Big Indian Lots, was introduced before the Town Board for the Town of Shandaken on October 2, 2017. And upon notice, duly published and posted a hearing was held on October 16, 2017 before the Town Board. And whereas public discussion was heard at such hearings concerning the merits and environmental significance of said introductory local law, where it was decided that the Planning Board perform the necessary State Environmental Quality Review, SEQR, for adoption at such time as the Planning Department seemed it prudent, and whereas the Planning Board Chair has made such request to move forward with this action. Therefore, be it resolved that the Town of Shandaken Town Board does hereby authorize the Town Planning Board to act as legal agent to act as lead agent regarding the seeker for local law number 2 of 2018, Big Indian Zoning Map Amendment, and to forward any such decision to the Town Board for their consideration, and move its adoption.
Second.
Board Member Alba?
Yes.
Board Member Duskafai?
Yes.
Board Member Storm?
Yes.
Board Member Van Walker?
Yes.
Supervisor Staley?
Yes.
Resolution 96-18, resolution setting public hearing for local law number 2, zoning amendment. Whereas the town would like to amend zoning for Big Indian parcels from mixed R1.5 and R5 to wholly R5, SBLs 12.7-2-7.141 and 12.7-2-7.2 under local law number 2 of 2018. Therefore, be it resolved that the Town of Shandaken Town Board does hereby call for a public hearing on a zoning amendment to be held Monday, August 6th at 6:45 p.m. at the Shandaken Town Hall, 7209 Route 28, Shandaken, New York, to hear all those in favor and against such actions. And I move this adoption.
Second.
Board Member Alba?
Yes.
Board Member Duskafai?
Yes.
Board Member Storm?
Yes.
Board Member Van Barca?
Yes.
Supervisor Lane?
Yes.
Resolution 9718, shared service agreement with Ulster County concerning county roads within the town of Shandaken. Whereas the county of Ulster, having its principal place of business at 240 Fair Street, Kingston, New York, 12401, here and after referred to as the county, and the town of Shandaken having its principal place of business at the Shandaken Town Hall, Route 28, P.O. Box 134, Shandaken, New York, 12480, here and after referred to as town. And whereas in the past, the town of Shandaken has had shared service agreements with other municipalities who possess similar shared service agreements authorizing the borrowing or lending of materials and supplies, and that exchanging, leasing, renting, and maintenance of equipment, including the operators thereof, for the purpose of aiding the highway superintendent in the performance of his or her duties. And whereas the town would like to enter into a similar agreement with the county, with this agreement being renewable every 5 years. Now therefore be it resolved by a majority of the town board that the town supervisor Robert A. Stanley and highway superintendent Eric Hoffmeister are authorized to engage in said shared service agreement for the period of July 9th, 2018 through July 9th, 2023. And move its adoption.
I'll second with an amendment. I'd like to strike in the title concerning county roads within the town of Shandaken. Oh. Just shared service agreement with Ulster County. That's a copy and paste error. Sorry.
I'll help out.
So a second?
Yes, I second.
You second?
Yes. Board Member Alba?
Yes.
Board Member Vincent Lai?
Yes.
Board Member Storm?
Yes.
Board Member Van
Wartum? Yes.
Supervisor Adam?
Yes. Resolution 9818, approved Highway Department Form 284, whereas the Town of Shandaken Highway Department is responsible for the maintenance and repairs to all town roads and bridges, and whereas the Town Highway Department is required to submit Form 284 to Ulster County Department of Public Works, or DPW, outlining proposed road and bridge repairs for the 2018 fiscal year. Therefore, be it resolved, the Town of Shandaken Town Board does hereby approve of the activities listed on Form 284 as submitted by the Highway Superintendent and the expenses budgeted and accounted for on Form 284, and move its adoption.
I'll second. Board Member Alba?
Yes.
Board Member Vizcafani?
Yes.
Board Member Storms?
Yes.
Board Member Van Larkin?
Yes.
Supervisor Adam?
Yes.
Resolution 99-18, hire engineering firm to assist in emergency bridge replacement. Whereas the Town of Shandaken Highway Department is responsible for the maintenance and repairs to all town roads and bridges, and whereas the Town Highway Superintendent has received confirmation of serious deficiencies regarding Church Street Bridge, the Bruce Story Memorial Bridge, in Big Indian, and whereas the Town Highway Superintendent requires the assistance of professional engineering services in order to repair said bridge, and therefore be it resolved that the Town of Shandaken Town Board hereby approves the hiring of Brinier and Larios, PC of 67 Maiden Lane, Kingston, New York, 12401, to perform services necessary for this emergency repair. And I move this adoption.
Second.
Board Member Alba?
Yes.
Board Member Lisa Klein?
Yes.
Board Member Storm?
Yes.
Board Member Van Larkin?
Yes.
Supervisor Stanley?
Yes.
Sure is.
I know you love the names. Resolution 100-18, resolution to hire summer camp counselors. Whereas under Section 20 notes of Decision 9 of the Town Law, the Town Board shall appoint all employees of the town. Therefore, be resolved that the Town Board of the Town of Shandaken, and upon the recommendation of the Director and Assistant Director of the Town of Shandaken Summer Recreation Program, hire the following individuals as camp counselors. Senior counselors at $300 weekly, Daniel Rice and Joseph Relia. Returning counselors at $275 weekly, Michaela Morton, Justin Blindberg, Brooke Harrison, Natalia Morton, and Jessica Rotella. And new counselors at $250 per week, Heather Rotella, Olivia Breck, and Gillian Kerrigan. Please be advised that all paid counselors shall receive 4 hours compensatory pay for mandatory orientation as required under state law, and move its adoption.
Second.
We said we needed one or two more counselors. What, if it's starting tomorrow?
We'll have to hire them retroactive at the next meeting.
Okay, and they'll get their training.
They'll get the training on the job. That's the only way. You don't have it outside.
Okay, and it's others of age?
16.
16.
Okay. And we posted that twice for 20 days.
Wow.
Yeah, and all over the internet. Board Member Alba?
Yes.
Board Member Vizcafani?
Yes.
Board Member Storm?
Yes.
Board Member Van Larkin?
Yes.
Supervisor Stanley?
Yes. You can do 101.
Yeah. Sorry, I spit it out. Resolution 101-18, resolution awarding transportation bid for summer recreation program field trips. Whereas the town of Shandaken summer recreation program will be taking two field trips during the coming season, and whereas the town advertised to receive bids for the following field trips: two buses for round trip to and from Battery Park, New York City, Statue of Liberty, Wednesday, August 1st, 2018, and two school buses for round trip to and from Zoom, Durham, New York, Wednesday, August 15, 2018. Therefore, be it resolved that the Town of Shandaken Town Board award the transportation contracts to...
Okay, we have one bid. Conchi Transit, Mount Trevor. Okay. Total price for both trips, $3,740. And they have the list of where the pickups are.
That's
great. Which would be the regular bus pickups.
Is that a lot of money?
It went up a bit.
No?
No.
But that's not a lot of money.
That's not a lot of money. No.
No, considering you got two charter buses going down to New York City.
And it's a motor coach.
Yes.
It's not a school bus.
It's a motor coach.
It says discount of $200 goes off the quarter price if Liberty Park is used to access the Statue of Liberty Ellis Island instead of Battery Park.
Okay, we'll have to work that out. Okay. Again, what they're saying?
$3,700.
So if you go on Jersey side, it's $200 less than the one in Manhattan.
So.
So I'll have to check with Circle Line because I don't know where if Circle Line leaves Liberty Park. Right now we're set on going for Battery Park, so we'll do it for that. And if we decide to move it to Liberty Park, then we'll just go at the discounted rate of 35, 40, or whatever maybe.
I'll give you a copy of that.
Yeah.
Who seconded it?
Yeah. Don't you have to say the amount and who needs to award it to?
So you want to say that?
Well, Gail should, because
okay.
Gail's
$3,000. Okay.
$3,740 going from the Battery Park side. Tanchi Transit.
I'll second.
Board Member Alba?
Yes.
Board Member Lisa Papali?
Yes.
Board Member Storm?
Yes.
Board Member Van Walken?
Yes.
Supervisor Stanley?
Yes.
And nobody can climb on the statue, right?
No one can climb on the statue, right?
Nobody can climb in the statue.
Resolution 102-18, resolution to hire firm to assist in town floodplain plan update. Whereas the Town of Shandaken Town Board and the Shandaken Area Flood Assessment and Remediation Initiative, SAFARI, members have been diligently working towards the efforts to help identify and reduce flood threats throughout the town. And whereas in 2013, the Town of Shandaken Town Board adopted the Town of Shandaken Flood Mitigation Plan, which identifies activities to help the town achieve the goal of reduction of threats from flooding, as well as helping to reduce the cost of flood insurance rates for the benefit of all town property owners. And whereas the Federal Emergency Management Agency requires disaster response plans to be reviewed and updated every 5 years in order to remain current and to assist in claims if such disaster does occur. And whereas the town has received a $47,500 grant from the Shokan Watershed Stream Management Program, to hire a consultant to assist the town in reviewing and updating said plan. And therefore, be it resolved, the Town of Shandaken Town Board, following the recommendation of SAFARI, hereby award this project to Tetra Tech, Inc., with offices located in 1000 America Road, Morris Plains, New Jersey, 07950. And I move its adoption.
Board Member Talba?
Yes.
Board Member DiScafani?
Yes.
Board Member Storm?
Yes.
Board Member Van Walken?
Yes.
Supervisor Stanley?
Yes. Open public comment, quick. Yes.
You know, we have to really think about some of the areas that need to be
Creekside Drive there. I told you that long before when everybody was going on Old 28. When they closed it down, I said, call the state and let the state get in there and pay and fix that. What are you going like this for?
I'm trying to figure out what you're talking about.
You're talking about the sinkhole, right?
You're talking about something.
No, I'm talking about Creekside Drive. The road is terrible. That should have been fixed by the DOT.
Yeah, okay, wait. It's not about the condition of the road, and yeah, there are issues there. This is about the new bridge that they just built. And they just opened up the entrance coming back from Creekside Drive and they redid it. And when you come out to go on to 28, the problem is with the new bridge location, you're looking straight at a 5-foot steel guide rail. You don't see the road or any oncoming traffic whatsoever.
But I had said a couple of years ago.
It wasn't up a couple of years ago.
Before they started this project, to go in there and fix Old 28 from Frank to fix all the way up. And you looked at me like I had four heads.
Yes.
Now, that should have been done before they even gave permission to put that bridge in.
Okay.
But now it's too late.
All right.
Now, what are you going to do about it?
What am I going to do about it?
Yeah.
I don't know what's for resurfacing the Creekside Drive and fixing the sinkhole that's there and stuff?
Well, the sinkhole.
That's not the only one in town.
I know. Well, there's
did you drive up Oliver Road?
Yeah, I was just going to mention that. Up there where Paul Herpin had the... There's a big hole there. Dig that all out.
About 49 in up
and
left.
Get some of the fill that's underneath the bridge down there, Big Indian, and put it all in there.
We can give you the list. Yeah. We got the list.
These things have to be done. What are we waiting for?